For me, one of the most inspirational moments in my life was when I watched Leander Paes win the Olympic bronze medal at the 1996 Atlanta Olympics. To see him stand on the podium, to see him win that medal, to see the Indian flag going up, to see that tear rolling down his cheek, I think was really inspiring. And at that very moment, I decided that I wanted to play for India at the Olympics. And that was the start of my dream.
My time in the US was when I was first exposed to the internet in a really big way. I still remember opening up my Gmail account when I was in university, and it had been about 15 days since it happened. And there was a lot happening around that because just right after the dot-com bubble, a lot of new business ideas were coming in, but were far more cautious.
So I remember the moment quite clearly, sitting at my desk at Goldman Sachs. This would have been 2003. And as an equity analyst, reading a tremendous amount on both China and India and the opportunities that this part of the world presented. And knowing that these were big and complicated markets, and knowing also that the only way to really gain context and understand was to be in them, I quit my job, put on a backpack for the next year and a half, and I traveled extensively throughout Southeast Asia, Asia, and in India for about 9 months. During that time, I traveled via trains, north, south, east, and west, to try and gain an understanding of this country, and was struck by the extraordinary opportunity, both professionally as well as personally.
Personally, when I think of Groupon, I think this is perhaps the best shot I will get in changing the way Indian consumers engage with the internet.
Olympic Gold Quest was founded by two of India's sporting legends, Geet Sethi and Prakash Padukone. The mission of OGQ is very focused, to help Indian athletes win Olympic medals. All of us have been athletes, all of us have been through the grind, and we have been frustrated that the talent was there but the support system never existed. And that's what OGQ aims to do. We aim to bridge the gap between where Indian athletes are currently and where we need to be to help challenge for Olympic medals.
So Espada is an early stage venture capital firm operating in India, focused on what we call essential services. India has a very vibrant venture capital ecosystem, but much of that money is focused on technology. We fund nuts and bolts businesses operating at the last mile, which are critical for improving livelihoods, and we think very important to the continued growth of the backbone of India Inc.
Everyone in my world knows this. The 1 year at ISB completely changed me as an individual.
I think for me at ISB, the biggest learning experience has been from the entire group environment, be it in study groups, be it with your classmates, be it with your quaddies.
Here I was like this linear science guy with just one unilateral perspective, and suddenly these multiple dimensions come in.
All coming from diverse backgrounds. One was an entrepreneur, one was a sales guy, one was a typical IT geek, and here was I, a sportsman.
When I look across the broader early stage funding ecosystem in India, I find entrepreneurs, I find venture capitalists, I find people in the startup community from across the ISB batches. There's a tremendous amount of entrepreneurial activity that comes directly out of the school. In fact, the first deal we did out of Espada Investment Advisors was found via the ISB networks and negotiated right here in this room.
When I look at my year or years post ISB, I think two things really changed. One is my ability to take risk. I'm a lot more confident, and as an entrepreneur, that is extremely important. And second is the network. The ISB alumni today is spread across the entire world, almost every company that you can think of. And as an entrepreneur, I know that these alumni or these companies are either my future clients or my future service providers. That, for me, is the ISB experience.
Years of work experience in IT services and a mother to a one-year-old, ISB for me was the answer to the question, where can I go for world-class business education without really compromising on these initial very special years with my daughter.
For me, it was the perfect bridge back to India.
I don't graduate with my degree only, but also with my business plan.
One thing that ISB really teaches you is to be humble. When I walked in, I was like this big guy. And then my study group, one guy is an army major, 21 years of experience. The other guy is an IIT Delhi grad, 9th rank. And the third guy is a national level footballer. And when you look at myself, just a run-of-the-mill chartered accountant.
To learn by doing, in shortest span of time.
Life-altering, life-changing.
Inspiring.
Immaculate.
Change the status quo.
Exhilarating.
Prioritizing.
I'm ready to get transformed by ISP.
I think your network is your net worth.
I still remember how my day started. Breakfast at the 33rd floor in the Four Seasons in Mumbai.
On the day I was with him, I attended some of the key meetings where we decided the Whistleblower Protection Act for whole of Tata Group.
My experience with him was very, very memorable. It's something that I cherish through my years after ISP.
This opportunity given to me by ISB for shadowing a CEO, I chose Dr. Mukund Rajan, who is one of the six key people of Tata Sons. He looks after CSR, branding and ethics. He is also the chief spokesperson of Tata Sons. I chose one of his working days. We planned for the whole CSR spending for next 1 year. We decided the media and web strategy for Tata Group, the Whistleblower Protection Act for whole of Tata Group.
Hi, my name is Yuvraj. I shadowed Kiran Majumdar Shaw and I was invited to meet her in the headquarters of Biocon in Bangalore. I was briefed by the strategy head of the company about how the company is investing into enzymes, and I happened to witness the felicitation and also the speech that she gave, and about how the investments in the enzyme industry and in pharmaceuticals is impacting lives of millions of people in India and also in other countries. I was invited during one of the parties of Nandan Nilekani, and I happened to meet Nandan Nilekani, Narayan Murthy.
I still remember how my day started. So I got to shadow Sudhanshu Vats, who's the CEO for the Viacom 18. And my day started with breakfast at the 33rd floor in the Four Seasons in Mumbai. What's even more amazing about my day spent at Viacom 18 is that they chose the day when they meet for the monthly performance review meeting. I got to sit at the board table with all the business leaders. So all the business heads were present on that day, on that table where I was sitting.
Hi, I am Kaveri. Before coming to ISB, I was working for the spiritual organization called Chinmay Vishnu. I've worked there for about a decade. I was teaching spirituality, so I was very interested in education, and therefore, for the Shadow CEO program, the CEO that I shadowed was Mr. Shantanu Prakash. He's the CEO for Educom. I was able to accompany him to a lot of events and planning programs. On our first day, we attended a program which was the foundation laying day anniversary for one of the schools of Educom.
The CEO I shadowed was Ashish Dhawan, who is the founder of Ashoka University Central Square Foundation as well as Kiss Capital. I had a pretty fascinating day. We started out with attending what is India's biggest development conference. Post that, we had a board call with the Tata Sons, and that had guys like Cyrus Mistry and Mr. Tata himself on board. There was a board meeting with the founders of Ashoka University. So there was a lot that Ashish packed in through the 8-hour day.
After those meetings, I visited the iconic Taj Hotel in Colaba On the lunch, we discussed about my career, their career, their career learnings, and what we can do to be successful in one's life.
Another thing I really picked up from Ashish was how he was going about his day. In that sort of 8-hour day, he achieved more than, you know, probably people do in a week.
Key learning that I had was from her personal life. So this was about how much difficulties she faced when she started her own company.
His ability to pick let's say the big influencers out of conversations and identifying the big levers. So I think that probably will come with practice, but it was fascinating just to watch. Another interesting memory I have is in the car when we were going for let's say snacks, etc. in the evening after we were done with the day, he was telling me how he went about raising his fund back in 1999, which is pretty tough time to sort of raise an India fund. And for me, somebody like me who intends to raise his own fund at some point in time, I think this is information that, or knowledge that, you cannot get out of books or videos or the internet, and you have to learn from somebody who's been there, done that.
What was very, very touching for me was that he thought of involving somebody like me, who was a complete novice, in helping him write his opening speech for the next day's summit.
My message to the future cohort of ISB would be to definitely explore this opportunity. I think it's a once-in-a-lifetime thing. And don't think of it as a transactional opportunity. So like, Ashish is still in touch with me now, and he keeps tab on how my career is going, what do I plan to do over the next few years. So I think this is sort of the start of a very sort of useful and meaningful relationship, and that's how it should be seen.
As we say, the success is only 1% inspiration and 99% perspiration. So if you give 100% to whatever you get, most probably you'll be successful.
I think it's a great opportunity, and I would like to summarize this by saying that this definitely opens doors.
Keep the ego on the side and value one for his work and his work alone. At the end of the day, whatever level you are, I mean, you're doing the same thing. So it's to see how leaders don't do different things, but they do things differently. And that's what really sets them apart.